President, do you ask Acting Attorney General Matthew Whitaker to change the leadership of the investigation into your former personal attorney, Michael Cohen?
No, not at all. I don't know who gave you that. That's more fake news. There's a lot of fake news out there. No, I didn't.
What is the current status of your relationship with Mr. Whitaker?
Very good. I have a lot of respect for Mr. Whitaker. I think he's done a great job. He's a very, very straight shooter. I watched him during the hearing, some of it. I thought he was exceptional. He's a very fine man, and he should be given a lot of thanks by our nation. Okay, thank you very much.
What's your reaction to the lawsuits yesterday filed by the states against your executive
board? Well, I think I called it exactly, right? Including the fact that they would put him into the Ninth Circuit. That's where they put him in. And I think we'll do very well. We have absolute right to do that. I have an absolute right to call national security. We need strong borders. We have to stop drugs and crime and criminals and human trafficking. And we have to stop all of those things that a strong wall will stop. I could call it a barrier, but I think I don't have to do that so much anymore. We'll call it whatever we want. But the point is that we have to have a stoppage. Billions and billions of dollars of illicit things are pouring through our border. And, you know, we talk about points of entry, and one of the things that we do have is a lot of money now for points of entry, because everything was given. The money was given so much that you almost don't know what to do with it by Congress. But when it came to the wall, they wanted to hold back because it was politics. That's all it is. In fact, I hear the Democrats want to take down all walls along the southern border. And if they do that, you're going to have a very different country. But they're not going to do that. They wouldn't. First of all, they won't do it because they know it's wrong. They know walls are necessary, maybe more than we do. But they're playing a political game. And their new game is, let's take down all walls. I saw where Beto wanted to take down walls. I said, they asked me, what do you think? I said, well, I think that's probably the end of his political career. We're doing very well in the wall. We're building a lot of wall right now. You know that. In the valley, we're doing tremendous work in a very important area. We have a lot more under negotiation right now. We're working with the Army Corps of Engineers. They're fantastic. And a lot of great things are happening. I think in the end, we're going to be very successful with the lawsuit. So it was filed. It was filed in the Ninth Circuit. And I actually think we might do very well even in the Ninth Circuit, because it's an open and closed case. I was put here for security, whether it's Space Force, which we're doing today, or whether it's borders. Because if our nation doesn't have borders, we don't have too much of a nation, especially when drugs and all of the things that you know better than anybody, what's happening at the border. It's a bad situation. So I think we're going to do very well with the lawsuit. Okay? Thank you.
You referred earlier to your meetings in Vietnam. What do you want to achieve during that summit?
Well, I'd just like to see ultimately denuclearization of North Korea. I think we will see that ultimately. I have no pressing time schedule, and I think a lot of people would like to see it go very quickly from the other side. I really believe that North Korea can be a tremendous economic power when this is solved. Their location between Russia, China, and South Korea is unbelievable. I think that North Korea and Chairman Kim have some very positive things in mind, and we'll soon find out. But I'm in no rush. There's no testing. As long as there's no testing, I'm in no rush. If there's testing, that's another deal. But there has been no testing. If you look at the end of the Obama administration, it was a disaster, what was going on. You don't have that right now. It's a much different feeling. I think people have — there's always danger, but I think people have a much different feeling. So I hope that very positive things are going to happen. I think that it'll be a very exciting couple of days. Thank you all very much. Bernie Sanders is running, yeah, that's right. Personally, I think he missed his time, but I like Bernie because he is one person that, you know, on trade, he sort of would agree on trade. I'm being very tough on trade. He would tough on trade. The problem is he doesn't know what to do about it. We're doing something very spectacular on trade, but I wish Bernie well. It'll be interesting to see how he does. I think what happened to Bernie maybe was not so nice. I think he was taken advantage of. He ran great 4 years ago, and he was not treated with respect by Clinton. And that was too bad. I thought what happened to Bernie Sanders 4 years ago was was quite sad as it pertains to our country. So we'll see how he does. You got a lot of people running, but only one person's going to win. I hope you know who that person is. Goodbye, everybody.
Thanks, guys. Press,
let's
go.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
All right, so we dipped in. President there, just quickly on the news, the breaking news out of the New York Times piece that they've been reporting that Trump spoke with his acting attorney general about the idea of getting the U.S. attorney for the SDNY to unrecuse himself so that he could maybe influence that Michael Cohen investigation. The president was asked about that. He denied any of those allegations in that New York Times piece that he tried to interfere and went on to say Matt Whitaker is a straight shooter and a very fine man. So wanted to put a button on that. I've got Kirsten and Anna with me still. And just let's just end with, you know, as we were talking about these, you know, Democratic contenders, and in 2020, you just heard the president ask Kirsten about, you know, Senator Sanders, and he thinks he's he likes Bernie, wishes him well. He was mighty complimentary. Why?
Because I think that this is the plan for Republicans is to focus on Bernie Sanders and talk about socialism and pretend that the plan for the Democratic Party is to somehow look like Venezuela, even though that's not even the kind of socialism that Bernie supports. But I think they see that as a real winning issue, is to just brand the entire Democratic Party as being socialist, which is still, for a certain amount of the population, a very kind of triggering word.
What do you think?
I think she's right. And I've got to tell you, as somebody who lives in South Florida, surrounded by Venezuelan exiles, I take great offense to Republicans or anybody comparing what's happening here to what's happening in Venezuela.
He mentioned socialism last night in that Miami speech 28 times.
Yes. And it worked in Florida for the Senate race and the governor's race, saying these Democrats want to turn the United States into Venezuela. Venezuela is a place where there is a thug dictator who is starving his people, who is killing his people, who is jailing his people, who is beating up his people. This is not Venezuela, and to use that metaphor for me just cheapens the distress and the despair of what is happening in that country. The one thing where I agree with Trump on is, you know, the leadership that the United States has taken vis-a-vis the international community and standing in solidarity with the Venezuelan opposition. Look, Bernie Sanders, he'd love to run against Bernie Sanders, but I've got to tell you, as I was listening to him right now, I thought it is the twilight zone in a moment where a Republican president is saying out loud that he agrees with Bernie Sanders on trade. I am so damn old. I remember when Republicans were pro-free trade. We're completely opposite where Bernie Sanders is on trade. Yet Donald Trump, who has taken this Republican Party hostage and has gotten a lot of fools to believe that he is the Republican Messiah, is in the same place. And he has said it in his own voice as Bernie Sanders on trade.